The Getty Center is located in Brentwood, California. It is about 10 miles from Hollywood and about 16 miles from downtown Los Angeles. This was my second visit. My first visit was in 2018 for an art class assignment. Join me for a tour of the grounds, the history of the Getty Center, and to get a deeper appreciation of selected artworks. The Getty Center has a very large parking structure that costs up to $20. Otherwise, admission is free. Everyone must ride the tram up to the museum, which affords some nice views. Is it just me, or does this place give you visions of art? This place is so big that I had to come twice to make this video, hence shots that don't match up. Weekdays are definitely better than weekends. This is the Arrival Plaza. It has maps in many languages. Then I went to the museum store, which is definitely not your typical gift shop. I found it very interesting that they had postcards of their art collection. The Getty Center exists today because of J. Paul Getty, and it is the embodiment of his view that art is a civilizing influence in society. J. Paul Getty was born December 15, 1892 in Minneapolis. He was introduced to the oil business by his father. They lived in Oklahoma for 2 years, after which they settled in Los Angeles. After attending the University of Southern California and the University of California, Berkeley, and earning a diploma in economics and political science, Getty prospected for oil, and he was a millionaire by age 23. Getty was a self-described nonconformist. Getty described himself as an art collecting addict. He started collecting art in 1904. Getty collected art with the same eye for underappreciated value that he had for a salt dome covering a rich store of oil. In 1954, Getty converted part of his ranch house into a museum so that he could share his art with the public. In 1974, Getty opened his first major museum in the style of a Roman villa, now known as the Getty Villa. J. Paul Getty's will turned his museum into the wealthiest art museum in the world. The Getty Center opened to the public in 1997, which marked 14 years since the 110-acre site was originally purchased, and 10 years since construction began. Architect Richard Meyer was hired to design the Getty Center Museum. Richard Meyer's buildings include the Barcelona Museum of Contemporary Art, the High Museum of Art in Atlanta, the flagship store of Peek and Cloppenburg, and the San Jose City Hall. And site-specific artist Robert Irwin designed the Central Garden. Robert Irwin was the first recipient of the MacArthur Genius Award in the arts. Today, J. Paul Getty Trust is the world's largest cultural and philanthropic institution dedicated to the arts. The Getty Center Museum is divided into four pavilions. The North Pavilion features art before 1700. The East Pavilion features art from 1600 to 1800. The South Pavilion also features art from 1600 to 1800, and the West Pavilion features art after 1800. The first piece that caught my eye was Holy Family with Saints Anne, Catherine of Alexandria, and Mary Magdalene. The artist, commonly known as Nocedella, is a mysterious figure whose career lasted only 20 years. Other notable works of his include The Holy Family with St. John the Baptist and The Annunciation. The next piece that caught my eye was An Allegory of Fortune, by an artist commonly known as Dosso Dossi. And here's another work I like, called An Allegory of Hercules. This is Cupid and Pan, which depicts Cupid, the god of love, subduing Pan, the god of the wild, by grabbing one of his ears. This painting represents the struggle between divine love and earthly love. The subject comes from a popular verse from the Roman poet Virgil, which translates to "Love conquers all." The authorship of this painting is unknown. Bacchanal by Alessandro Magnasco depicts an ancient pagan feast celebrating Bacchus, the god of wine. These are some of his other works that I like. This is An Old Man in Military Costume, and it is by none other than Rembrandt. He specialized in character studies. And Rembrandt Laughing by none other than Rembrandt. By the late 1620s, he was producing small single-figure studies of various emotional states with the help of a mirror. He did this in his early 20s, and it is a rare depiction of happiness. Rembrandt Laughing is another Getty Center highlight. Honestly, I am not a big fan of Rembrandt. Shipping in a calm at Flushing with a States General yacht firing a salute. This artist specialized in marine paintings. Bacchante with an Ape by Hendrik Terbruggen is one of the top pieces at the Getty Center. It portrays a Bacchante, a female follower of Bacchus, the god of wine. And these are some of his other works that I like. The Entombment by Peter Paul Rubens depicts the moment after the crucifixion and before the resurrection of Jesus Christ. John the Evangelist, in the brilliant red robes, supports the body of Christ, while Mary, the mother of Christ, cradles his head. I must say that Peter Paul Rubens is one of my favorite painters that I have discovered at the Getty. Check out some of these other works. Especially this painting of Medusa. Triumph of the Marine Venus depicts the mythological goddess Venus sitting atop a throne pulled by muscular men and surrounded by her entourage. And more from Sebastiano Ricci. Thank you. calm at a Mediterranean port. This is another painter who specialized in marine subjects. As in this one, also at the Getty, a storm on a Mediterranean coast. And here are some of his other works. The Glorification of the Union of the Houses of Habsburg and Lorraine. This was painted as a final model for the ceiling fresco of the Great Hall in the Imperial Palace in Innsbruck, Austria. Portrait of Louis XIV by Jacinth Rigaud. This is one of the many copies the artist had made due to the popularity of the original, which is in Paris in the Louvre. He was famous for his portraits of French nobility. And these are some of his other works. The Farewell of Telemachus and Eucharis by Jacques-Louis David. Telemachus, the son of Odysseus, falls in love with the nymph Eucharis. However, duty to his family requires that he end their romance in order to search for his missing father. And Jacques-Louis David also did this one of Napoleon Bonaparte's nieces, capturing sisterly affection and contrasting personalities. I was surprised to learn that he also did these famous paintings of Napoleon and the Oath of the Horatii. I found this to be a very beautiful portrait. The artist became known for flattering portraits of royalty and upper-class society. I don't know how to pronounce this artist's name, but having looked up his other works, he is also one of my favorite new painters that I discovered at the Getty. Just check out all these lovely portraits. I overlooked this one at the museum, but I found it during my research. This is Portrait of a Woman by Jan Meetens. The elaborate hair and pearls identify her as a woman of status. He was known for portraits of patrons at the highest levels of society, including the royal court. These are some of his other works that I enjoyed discovering. And another one I overlooked. This is a portrait of a woman who epitomized ideal beauty in the late 1600s. and she still looks pretty good today. She worked as a spy for Louis XIV and was the favorite mistress of Charles II. Charles II created the position of Duchess of Portsmouth for her. And these are some of his other works. And one more that I discovered online, Young Woman with a Fan by Pietro Antonio Ritari. In fact, he is one of my favorite discoveries from the Getty. Check these out for yourself. Self-Portrait Yawning by Joseph Ducrot. He wanted to capture facial expressions not previously done in portraits. And these are some of his other works. Quite fun. And another Getty Center highlight, Spring by Manet. Manet was a French modernist painter. He was one of the first 19th century artists to paint modern life and a pivotal figure in the transition from realism to impressionism. Actress Jean de Marcy was selected as the embodiment of spring. His other works are among the most distinctive of all the artists in the Getty. And yet another highlight of the Getty Center, Irises by Vincent van Gogh. After he cut off his own ear, he checked himself into an asylum. This painting is part of a series he did of the asylum garden. And these are some of van Gogh's other works. I hope you enjoyed all that art appreciation. Honestly, when I come to museums, I usually just take a quick look and move on. I feel many people are like me. This time I went deeper for the video. Then I went to the gardens. Honestly, I did not love them as much this time as I had the first time I visited. I saw a girl doing handstands, so I figured I better join in. You know, I think these gardens are best in the spring. Then I went to the Getty Research Institute, which typically has its own special exhibits, and it also has a library, which requires reservations. Then I went back to the gardens to kill some time. Next was the cafe. The restaurant was closed. The cafe is one of the most beautiful I have been to. Looking at the restaurant menu online, it is gourmet and it changes seasonally. Past menus have had duck and chocolate crepes, among other appetizing options. Either way, it looks like a tasty good time. There were some great quotes in the J. Paul Getty exhibit that I will finish with. To me, my works of art are all vividly alive. They are the embodiment of whoever created them, a mirror of their creator's hopes, dreams, and frustrations. Let me just say, as a lifelong movie fan, I feel the same way about movies, and I feel the same way about my own videos. I am convinced that the true collector does not acquire objects of art for himself alone, appreciating the beauty of the objects, he is willing and even eager to have others share his pleasure. The collector can at will transport himself back in time and walk and talk with great Greek philosophers, the emperors of ancient Rome, the people great and small of civilizations long dead, but which live again through the objects in his collection. Few human activities provide an individual with a greater sense of personal gratification than the assembling of a collection of art objects that he feels have true and lasting beauty. Thanks for watching the video. Show your art's appreciation by hitting the thumbs up and subscribing if you are new.